Let's do it. Is my arm still in there?
Oh, my arm's still in there. That was bad.
Hey, it's your boy Nathan here, aka Six Cinema. Welcome back to the channel. If you haven't hit that subscribe button, make sure you do it. And as always, make sure you have that notification bell because you want to know when I'm posting videos, right? Anyway, for today's video, we are going to be testing out the Rode Wireless Go. So let's go. Okay, let's get into it. The Rode Wireless Go, I was going to do an unboxing for it, but there's not much in this box, to be honest. All you get is you get the receiver and you get the transmitter. Look at this. Two little tiny things in this box. Other than the receiver and the transmitter, you obviously get cable in the box to attach that receiver to your camera. So you got this right here. The only other things that you get is this little Caterpillar windscreen and of course the case to hold it all. And this, honestly, this is a tiny case, so it doesn't take too much room in your camera bag, which is probably the best part so far, because looking at how tiny these things are, it's perfect for on-the-go videographers like myself. So if we take a little deep dive of what's on this transmitter and receiver, there's honestly not too much. You got the power button, obviously, because you want to turn these on. If we look at the transmitter first, it's pretty simple. You have a little clip here on the back where you can clip it to your shirt here. And you also have a little microphone on top of this transmitter because unfortunately, this does not come with a lavalier mic, which could be a hit or miss for some people depending on who you are. I know a lot of people would want to have a lav so they can hook it to their shirt and it's a little hidden. But for me, it's not that big of a deal because I found a little quick trick that you can use to hide this transmitter and not have to use a wireless lav. So you got the mic on top, so it captures audio, so you don't need that lav, like I said. You have the USB-C port for charging because USB-C port charging is like, it's the future, I guess, you know? And that's about it on this transmitter. So if we look at the receiver, so you have the power button, you got the little clip on the back, again, so you can clip this to your camera. There's a little LCD screen here which shows you the levels of the mic that you're using. It also shows the battery power, which is pretty cool, so you don't have to guess what your battery level is at. There's also a dB button in it, which has three different channels where you can set it to 0 dB, negative 12 dB, and negative 24 dB, I'm pretty sure is what it is. I'll check the specs later. I'll probably throw them right here if I'm saying the wrong thing. And then the last button that's on this receiver is the pairing button. And because these came together, they are automatically paired together. So you don't have to worry about that. But if you went and bought another transmitter, you would have to use the pairing button to pair that with the transmitter that you get. So why don't I take the shotgun off my camera that I'm recording with currently, and let's play with this Rode Wireless Go, because that's what we're here for. We're testing it out. So let's go. Okay, so now we have the Rode Wireless Go hooked up. Hopefully you can hear me. You could probably hear me because I did check the levels before I started filming. This windscreen that comes with it. We'll test it out. We'll put it on here. The one thing that I've found so far while using this is that this windscreen pops off really easily. Sometimes if I'm hooking it up onto my shirt, it'll just randomly pop off and I almost lost it a couple times. So I probably won't use this as much as I thought at first. So we're gonna take this off because I don't wanna lose it. We're gonna get some running going. I'm gonna hook this up to my chest. And the one thing that I found, if you wanna wear this without a lavalier mic, the one thing you can do is get an undershirt and hook this to your undershirt. If you hook this to your undershirt and wear another shirt over top, it works perfectly to hide the transmitter. And now I don't need the wireless lav. And I could just run over here and you can hear me. I can run over here and you can hear me. That's one of the tricks that I learned when I first got this, is I didn't want to buy a wireless lav because sometimes they get a little expensive and I don't like having the wire hooked up to me. So if you just hook this to your undershirt, it's not too close that your voice becomes overpowering and you're peaking. So it's just in a nice spot and it's nice and hidden, so no one even knows that you're wearing a mic. So yeah. Okay, so now we're gonna go through a quick range test to see how far you can go with these mics. Let's just test it. Honestly, Tory Lanez is on everything right now. It's kind of crazy. I don't know if you can hear me, but I'm just gonna keep walking back. I got my brother on the camera there. He's gonna pull the zoom so you can zoom in a little bit more and see me. I don't know if you can still hear me, but I'm gonna just make my way back. Let's just run it back. Maybe I should have put the windscreen on. My cardio sucks. I say that's about 100 yards that run, but damn, I'm tired. Whew, that's pretty far if you could hear me the whole time. And I don't think I'll need it any further because I usually have my camera right on me at all times, but we are in plain view. There's nothing really blocking us. There's no concrete around. We might have a stronger connection with the receiver and the transmitter right now. I bet if I went back downtown and tried to do this, the concrete bouncing the transmission all over the place, I won't be able to walk as far. So far, so good. Okay, so it's starting to get dark out, so let's head back inside and we're gonna talk a little more about what I liked and what I disliked about this microphone, but so far, so good. Okay, so I'm back at my place. It is the next day because it was kind of late when I got back, but I took a look at all the footage and honestly, the audio sounds crisp and it's probably one of the best mics I've had so far. I might be using this a lot more than my shotgun mic that I usually use, but I guess it just depends on the situation. Like I said earlier in the video, I'm probably not gonna get a wireless lav for this, but if you do want a wireless lav, it has a spot available where you're able to plug one in, but I like the way it is right now, and I don't really need to spend the money on a wireless lav at this point. It is a great mic and it is great quality, and I would definitely recommend it to anyone that's creating videos. As always, make sure you hit that subscribe button and also turn on that notification bell, but if you don't know, I do post videos every single week on Sunday, so just come back here on Sundays and I'll have a brand new video for you. Anyway, that's it for me this week. I'll see you next time. Take it easy. Peace.